Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we are going to be drawing the phase logo. So what you will need for this? It's pretty simple. You need a pencil, an eraser, a scale, and these are the three items that you will mainly need. The other two additional items are going to be a white pen and a black pen. You can use these if you want for extra details. I'll use the black pen. I don't need the white pen for this. So these are the four items that you will need, along with a piece of paper. So good luck, and let's start the video. So for the phase logo, it's a backward F and a frontward F, with a wider gap between the two lines. So, first we'll take our scale, and I'm going to draw the line with a measurement of how many centimeters the line is supposed to be right next to it. You can take that measurement and draw it onto your drawing as well. Now, if you feel I'm going too fast, you can always slow down the video and then you can catch up with me once you're done. Now, once you're done with the rectangle, keep your scale on a 45 degree angle approximately and draw a line so that it is like this and it's formed a triangle below. Now, you are going to want to erase the triangle below and keep the slanted line instead. Now, please ignore this part. I have marked it as 3.5 centimeters, but actually the real marking needs to be 5 centimeters because this is just the initial marking. At the end, I'm going to increase it by 1.5 centimeters later because the logo doesn't come out properly when it's just 3.5. Again, please ignore this as it is not correct, and I need to increase the top line by 1.5 centimeters on both sides. So don't draw the slanted lines or any of these lines of the backward F just now. Just erase it if you have already drawn it, since the proportions are wrong. Now follow this one, because this one is the actual measurement that you're supposed to do, not the previous one. So you could have skipped from there to this point. Now pause the video right now and then just take down the measurements. The line thickness is supposed to be 1.5 centimeters and the gap between the two lines over here is supposed to be 1 centimeter. So you can take that from the top line and measure it down. Now one part of the logo is done. We are going to move on to the other side now. Follow as I show you, since this part is not an exact mirror copy and it's a little bit different. Hey! the line measurement is supposed to be 18 millimeters or 1.8 centimeters. Make the slant as exact as possible. It should look like the other side slant. So you don't have to be very exact, but just try to replicate it. So, if you didn't get how to draw that, you see the slanted line on the bottom. The middle of it is where I took the measurement for the left side slanted line. For the right side, I moved the dot a little onto the right and I took that slanted line measurement. So that's how you drew the slanted line, and I matched it along with the other side top F line. Now that we're done with the drawing, let's outline in time lapse. Now that we're done outlining, let's move on to the coloring part. Wow, this is the final outcome. I just used a pencil, pen, eraser, scale, and a few colors. That's all. In fact, it was just one color. Now, the measurements weren't proper at first, but I changed it up a bit, and then it turned out just fine. So, if you like this video, then make sure that you like and subscribe down below. Also, if you want to see something else next, make sure that you comment in the comment section also, so that I know what you guys want to see and what you guys want to draw as well. I'll make those videos as well sometime soon. So also make sure to share it with your friends so I can gain more subs. So that's all for today. Bye.